Alright, I just bought these couple of bits of metal out of the scrapyard. They were 20 quid each. So I'm thinking about making a tipping trailer out of them. Using the bed off my old truck. I have it pulled off and all. The truck isn't working anymore. It's just needs too much work done to it to pass the MOT, and it started burning oil, engine oil, so it's not worth fixing. So I'll get one of these inside and start working on it. I'll get back to you when I get it inside. Alright, I just want to build this trailer here using this recycled heavy gauge C channel. It's about 8 millimeters thick. I had two of these here frames, so I cut one of them up. That's the off cut of one there and there. So I need to cut a piece off this one to go in here, and the other bit will do for the hitch to go on to. I'm going to clean everything up too. So I'll get stuck into it here. I'll put you on time lapse here and do a wee bit. I'm just giving you the update on this trailer. I have it all welded up there. Need to put the leaf springs on it and flip it round and finish welding it. There's a few wee bits I have to tidy up. and come through the welding. Yeah, but that's mocked up. These leaf springs have just arrived. Well, I think it's the leaf springs. These heavy duty 7 leaf springs and all the bits that come with it. Yeah, hopefully it does the job. Ordered these lights too, just to see if I'm wiring it, so I can just take these magnets off and then mount these to the trailer somewhere. Yeah. Well, I'll start mocking them up here on the trailer to see which way they're going to look. I'll get back to you. Alright, I have them all sitting there where I want them. Yeah, I've marked it on the frames. On the frame there where I want. Yeah. These to go. Yeah, that was the reason why I welded this bit here on it, just to give it a bit more width for the wheels. Yeah, so that's it, ready to go. I'll do another bit of welding here and get these welded on. I'll stick these on time lapse. That's the first axle on it. That's on a Ford Transit Mark 7. Yeah, I have another one to go on the other one too. Alright, that's it all right there. Yeah. I'm going to lift it with a digger and bring it outside and then flip it over. And then I can finish welding it. And then give it a coat of paint. But I'll lift it here and see how it goes. Right, that's it. Yeah. Just have to do the last bit of welding. I need to tidy up these bits. I didn't do a good job cutting these here. Yeah, that's the first time I ever cut a piece of metal like that. But I think it'll be alright once I keep filling it up with weld, and then I'll grind it down. But the rest of it's dead on. Just have to tidy it up again. Right, take all the rust off it. Any surface rust on it, it's still good metal underneath it. That there is 100 mil by 50 mil, and it's 8 inches or 8 mil thick steel, quarter inch thick. And it's going to have, these are four transit axles. It's going to have disc brakes on it. Yeah, why I chose the Ford Transit. Chose the Ford Transit actually, as it has these here. And these cables to break them, break the discs, or break the pads. So I'll figure out what I'm going to do next here on the back piece. Alright, it's day three of building this trailer. Yeah. I'm going to finish welding it here because I flipped it over, and then sand it down or grind it down, take all the rest of the surface rust off it, and then paint it. Yeah. And then tomorrow I can start putting the tipper body on. Yeah. It'll only be a half day the day. I finished work early today, so I'll get this finished and get it ready for tomorrow so I can put the tipper body on. Yeah. Well, I'll get stuck in it here. I just put longer bolts into that hitch there. I'm shooting out of it through the brace. I've made this up, so I want to give it a go here. So we just cut this the length, marked it and cut it there. We just had to tail onto this bit of the hitch. So I only have two of these cables, so I need to order an offset, but of the barn all in there, I need to order an offset of cables on one of them. I managed to take these cables and that they're off my transit van, but when I ordered, when I went and picked up the new axle, the same as this one that I had, the transit one, the fella cut the cables, I told him not to, and ended up, I didn't have the cables in, but I got money off the purchase. Label I got there from the hand, and I'll adjust it. There's another bar here to do the same with this axle, so the both axles will be able to break, and I'll have disc brakes instead of drum brakes. That was the whole reason I wanted to use four transit axles. I like the way they drop down that 4 or 5 inches. The way they're made. No, to make it a wee bit lower, fit the tipper bed on, so you're not driving up with the digger so high onto the back of the tipper bed. So I just need to stick some cable ties on these, just tie them up nice. And then they're ready to go. That's it, ready to hook on to the van and give it a wee tow to see what it's like before I put the tipper bed on. I'll do that first and I'll get set up here and I'll do that first. trailer underneath it, see if I can drag it off. I'll just set it over here out of the road. I can sort it with a trailer. It's busy with work as well, never got a chance to do it. We'll lift it up here anyway and see how it goes. Hopefully it doesn't tip over. That's it on there now. I just had to line it up and bolt it on, but I'll get back to you once I get that done. All right, I've just finished wiring this here. I'm roughly in there an hour, so I'll just need to tidy it up a wee bit. So I just had to tidy it up, find some way to keep bolt the battery in there. Yeah. So that's working at the minute. That's it, seems to work alright. A wee bit of rust here, I want to cut this out and put a wee bit of metal in there. That's the worst part. Alright, I just want to put some weight on it here and see what way it handles. Yeah, see how far it lowers down on the suspension. Some oil here to get up. More than 3 times.
ton on it there. She seems to handle it alright. Alright, I'm just doing a last take here on this video. I know it was a bit long. If you made it to the end, thanks for watching. Just done a wee breakdown here on how much it cost me. So it was $320 for the hitch and jockey wheel, £40 for them two bits of metal, the frames, $160 for the leaf springs, $20 for the lights. And I was just allowed now £60 for nuts and bolts and stuff, so that was £600. And the trailer I wanted to buy was over £6,000. It was a brand new trailer, Brian Jameson one, or else an Ivor Williams one. So as if you made it to the end of the video, thanks for watching. I have a few odd videos that I'm thinking of doing. That's the trailer. It's more or less finished. There's a few wee bits to tidy up on the lights to put on, and an odd two brake cables to put in, but that they're handy enough done. If there's anything else interesting, I'll do a wee video on it. A few odd projects I'm looking to do on record. One of them is, well, I bought this QR off my dad. It's was going to the scrap yards. The timing chain snapped in it. I'm gonna give it a go trying to fix it. I've never took an engine apart, but I'll give it a go and see what happens. I bought this QR port. So I'm not gonna put like an addition or an extension on this workshop of mine to keep turn it into like a metal working shop, because I'm looking to do more metal working projects. I usually build stuff out of timber and do landscaping and stuff, but I'm just starting to get into metal working. So I can keep the shed for storage and woodworking stuff. I'm looking to tidy all this outside here too once I have this built. Doing all wee bit round the side there to put all that bricks and pallets and stuff into it. So as I say again, if you made it to the end of the video, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and do a wee thumbs up. Thanks again, Banner.